Honorable, kindly tell us, as the Deputy Minister of Information, Communication and Technology, what is the ministry's plan to make sure that the ordinary citizen and community members all over the country, especially in the rural areas, are updated on time and in the language they understand on the issue of COVID-19?
Thank you very much, Fidel. Yes, of course. As you may know, actually today marks only 2 weeks since I've taken over office, myself and my minister. And being the mouthpiece of government, the Ministry of Information, Communication, Technology is very vital to ensuring that every Namibian, especially at this difficult time, gets information about COVID-19 and how they can prevent themselves from contracting the virus, but also the further spread, because you might not die from it or suffer from it, but you passing it on to someone else might cause their death or might cause them to be too ill to be able to support their family and so on. So just some of those things. So from our perspective, what we have done up to date is, one, as you can see, set up this communication center that we're at now, because we recognize that the different government ministries in communicating, like today we had education, yesterday we had law enforcement agents, the other day we had trade and industry, Minister of Gender. There were a lot of channels in which the ministries were communicating in isolation and in silos. We wanted to have a central place where the media, which is a very big stakeholder and we recognize as MICT, to assist us in sending out the message. Of course, you raised a very important issue around people in the most vulnerable societies in the rural areas not understanding the messages we want to put across, because either it's not reaching them on time or they're not understanding it in the language that they are native to. So one, to allow them to get the information on time, we have partnered up with NBC, for example, to be our central organization to be able to disseminate information on television, on the radio stations, in all the radio stations, no matter what language they communicate. And then the assistance of the people managing that radio station to be able to translate whatever information that is being said here at the COVID-19 communication center. But also in addition to that, we asked all media houses in the country, private, whatever you do, to come here as well and be able to tap into whatever is being communicated here. So the information goes on your Facebook, on your Twitter, on YouTube, whatever you're using to communicate the message. We have said, come, we'll connect you, so the message goes out to everyone and on time. But most importantly, as MICT, we have initiated a process of preparing pamphlets. We have already prepared them in English. They've been in circulation for about a week and a half now. But we have now translated them into all Namibia's indigenous and vernacular languages. The reason being that issue raised about people not getting information in their native languages. So those are being disseminated today across Namibia. We have an MICT office in every region. So those have been sent out. They're going to all of those regions, so they're able to disseminate them, whether it's the regional councils, whether it's at the hospitals, whether it's going door to door to community members, households, to give them this pamphlet. Tell them what COVID-19 is, how you can contract it, how you can avoid not contracting it, and how we can ensure we stop the spread. So that has been really our initiative. Of course, you can see that is a lot to do. We really needed the support of our staff, and I'm very happy that they really came on board to try to get the message out there, working administratively here and there, and so far we are doing well. Of course, there are a lot of improvements we could make, and that's why we have our COVID.nam@mict.gov.na email to also get people to really send in their queries and questions, so we answer them there and then, or answer them as we have our updates daily at 10 o'clock in the morning or 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So we're really trying to use every avenue available, every tool at our disposal, in order to ensure the information is sent out to our community members.
Honorable, my last question is based on the challenges that as a deputy minister, very young, and you just took office recently. What challenges do you oversee, especially in terms of information dissemination, and especially the fact that a lot of young people are looking up to you and they're also expecting so much from you? So what challenges are you overseeing in terms of your operation or to execute your duties?
As you may know, already at my appointment, there were questions about experience, around if I'm ready for the role. I'm not in a position to answer that anymore. I think perhaps my actions must just speak for themselves. I don't know. It's really for the nation to judge how well we are managing, for example, this community center, or how well we are communicating the message around COVID-19. It's really up to them to judge. But as I've reiterated before, I'm ready to get advice, guidance on how we can improve the communication machinery in the country. My ministry, of course, as you know, is very central to that. For me, it's just service, to serve my deliverables as those that have been placed on me by His Excellency Dr. Hage Geingob, that when He appointed me, He wanted me to achieve certain things, and I think I'm well on track on achieving those. But I would also like to highlight that as a young person, and one of very few in the 30 years we've been independent, to not only serve in parliament but also serve in cabinet, I think it's important to know that I seek the support of young people, and I'm very happy that so far many have reached out to me with their ideas, plans. Of course, because of COVID-19, I can't respond as I would like to some of those great ideas because of the predicament we find ourselves in, but I invite young people to come on board and help me bring a youthful outlook to the ministry, a youthful outlook to government, a youthful outlook to governance as a whole. Of course, being a deputy minister is not all that I'm doing. I'm also going to be a lawmaker, influencing laws that affect all of us as Namibians. But as a young person, I'm better able to articulate the needs of young people. So I would like to encourage them, just like they did before I was deputy minister, or before I was in parliament, how we continued engaging, debating issues, so that I'm able to take that to the house that is able to bring that into action. So really, that's just my plea and my call to young people, to not be quick to judge, quick to complain. Let us work together to serve our interests and needs as young people, because this is an opportunity His Excellency Dr. Hage Geingob has given us. We need to take advantage of it. We need to take advantage of it. Really, that's my message. Thank you. Thank you for having me.